Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Rashid. I am a brother from the United States. I'm here in London for One Ummah TV. I just want to, inshallah, give my story of how I came to Islam and maybe give some advice for people who are trying to find their way on along that path, inshallah. Stay tuned. Bismillah. As we know now, my name is Rashid. I'm from Florida in the United States, the Orlando area, you know, outside Orlando. I'm 24 years old. I came to Islam in December of 2004, so I was 17 at the time. Alhamdulillah. Currently, I work as an optical lab technician, so alhamdulillah. Life before Islam. Well, generally, I was basically like a church kid, you know. I was raised in the Southern Baptist Church. I went to church very frequently, Bible studies and services and whatnot. So I knew my Bible. I was not very knowledgeable enough, you know, for a kid of, you know, 13 to 17 is when I really got into it. So yeah, life before Islam, church kid, you know, went to school, church, that was basically it, you know. Okay, before reverting, let's see, as I said, I was a very, you know, strong, firm believer in the Trinitarian Christian faith, as I was a Southern Baptist. You know, feel free to go on and on your own time and look up what they believe, but I was very firm in this faith. I didn't know much about Islam to have an opinion, and that was kind of self-imposed ignorance, I guess you could say, because of how the media portrays Islam. And so I didn't want to go there. I was like, I don't know, like afraid of what I might learn, you know. And about Islam, I didn't know much. I thought whatever the news told me, but, you know, basically. Okay. Yeah, like I said, I didn't know much about Islam, but I had actually done my fair share of homework on Buddhism, Hinduism, and that's just, you know, based on pure curiosity and interest in, I guess, Eastern cultures, you know. And having been brought up in the Christian faith, going to Bible studies, you get kind of a cursory, you get basic information about Judaism because the Old Testament is incorporated into the Bible. So I guess, I knew a little bit about Judaism, basic tenets of Hinduism and Buddhism, Taoism, not much, Shinto, a little, because the whole culture over there, I had a big interest in, you know. But yeah, so the major religions, I did look into a little bit, you know, in the basics at first. Okay, well, first, I never went on like a journey to find the truth, because being raised in the church as firmly as I had been, I'd always assumed that I was upon it already. So what actually happened was, there was another revert brother that I went to school with. We were pretty good friends at the time anyway. But having been raised in this Christian environment and finding out that he had left the faith that I loved so much, I was like personally offended that he chose to leave it. So I took it upon myself as kind of like a crusade to like bring him back to the church, you know what I mean? You know, witness to him and all this kind of thing, but, you know, without knowing anything about his religion. But, you know, I tried my best, and through that, I guess the way I went about it was wrong. Like I said, I didn't know anything about Islam, so what I had to do at first was finally research about Islam on my own and through asking him also, because we would have various, you know, kind of debates on doctrinal issues, whatever. So we'd discuss, and he would teach me this aspect of Islam and this aspect, and I, what do I say to that now? Because I didn't know that before, and it makes sense to me, so what do I say, you know? I had nothing to say. And so, as this went on, actually, my mission to bring him out of Islam led me to Islam, alhamdulillah. And yeah, that's what, I didn't go on a search for truth like, you know, mashallah, some people do. Like, they just find it within themselves that they want to go out and find the truth. I didn't. I guess, you know, Allah guided me in the way that He did. So, alhamdulillah. Well, gotta be totally honest and say, like, it really hasn't changed that much because of how I was raised and, like, going to church a lot. You know, my lifestyle, per se, didn't really change that much. I just picked up a few extra prayers per day and stopped eating bacon, really. No more pork. I didn't indulge in alcohol, you know, at that time anyway, so I didn't have to really leave it. Just had to stop eating pork and pray a few extra times a day.
Did your belief in God change?
My belief in God did not. I'll be honest, because the Trinitarian doctrine, right, that I'd always just accepted because that's what we believed, right? I just accepted it. I didn't understand it. So, you know, if you don't understand something, how can you really say that you believe it? So I never really, I can say with confidence that I never really did believe in a triune God. I believed, you know, that there is God. But what did change was my belief in Jesus, peace be upon him, and his relationship to God, his relationship to us, and yeah, so that's what really did change. Well, from the bottom of my heart, I really have to just say, you know, just do it, because it to me. And, you know, speaking from reason, it is the only way of life that people should be following. It's the complete way of life that you won't find in any other religion, and it's the most logical, I guess, doctrine you can say that you won't find in any other religion. It makes perfect sense. And the way of life that is encouraged and commanded by God is the perfect way of life. It really is. So my advice would be to just, you know, make sure that's what you want for yourself, and just do it. You know, don't worry about, you know, don't worry. Just put your trust in God. You know, that's all I can say. Just do it. And put your trust in God.
If they have any questions, would you prefer to, if they have any doubts?
Well, you know, if you have any Muslim friends that you're already in contact with that may be teaching you about Islam, or that you've come to with questions, you know, ask them. And don't be shy. Don't be shy to ask them to bring you to, you know, the mosque that they go to talk to their imam or some of the other knowledgeable brothers in the congregation. So don't be shy to ask questions also. Well, I first want to say, if you have just decided to take on this path, then congratulations. And you all have my prayers for continued guidance and success in this life and in the next life, the real life. Advice would be just be wary of where you get your information from. Don't be hasty to join up with a sect. You know, all these slogans and everything. Just, you know, learn your information, go slow, you know. This is the beginning of the path, you know, you just started. It's, you know, you're not gonna, you know, attain ultimate truth, you know, within a year or something. It's, you know, just take your time. Always make sure to purify your intention and make sure that it's, you know, whatever you're doing is for the sake of, for the sake of Allah and in His worship. And yeah, that's it. So, brothers and sisters in Islam, and hopefully, inshallah, new brothers and sisters in Islam, I hope that my words could benefit you in some way, inshallah, I hope, and inspire you to embrace Islam or to progress on the path that you're on, inshallah. Yeah, that's it. My name is Rashid. Keep me in your prayers, inshallah. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Islami wa imani adaa al-kawn wa zamanu bi islami wa imani adaa al-kawn wa zamanu bi islami وإيماني أضاء الكون والزمن بإسلامي وإيماني أضاء الكون.